This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. SMS Kronprinz Erzherzog Rudolf was a unique ironclad warship built for the Austro-Hungarian Navy in the 1880s. The last ironclad completed for the Austro-Hungarian Navy, Kronprinz Erzherzog Rudolf, was laid down in January 1884, launched in July 1887, and completed in September 1889. She was armed with a main battery of 3 305 cm 120. Design. In the decades that followed the Austrian victory at the Battle of Lissa in 1866, naval expenditure in the Austro-Hungarian Empire were drastically reduced, in large part due to the veto power the Hungarian half of the empire held surrounded by potentially hostile countries' powers on land. The Austro-Hungarian Empire was more concerned with these threats, and so naval development was not prioritized. Admiral Friedrich von Pock argued for several years to improve the strength of the Austro-Hungarian fleet, finally winning authorization to build the center battery ship Tegetthoff in 1875. He spent another 6 years trying in vain to secure a sister ship to Tegetthoff. Finally, in 1881, Pock succeeded in securing funding for a new ironclad, authorized as Ersatz Salamander, a replacement for the earlier ironclad frigate. The new ship, to be named Kronprinz Erzherzog Rudolf, cost $544,976.35 caliber guns mounted singly in open barbettes. Two were placed forward in sponsons over the battery deck to maximize end-on fire, with the third placed aft. The guns were manufactured by Krupp, while the carriages that carried them were built by Armstrong Mitchell. Kronprinz Erzherzog Rudolf was protected with compound armor manufactured by the Dillinger Hut Works in Germany. The ship's armored belt was 305. Stephanie, and the protected cruiser Kaiser Franz Joseph I were sent to Germany under the command of Rear Admiral Johann von Hinck. While en route, the squadron made visits in Gibraltar and Britain. During the latter stop, the ships took part in the Cowes Regatta, where they were reviewed by Queen Victoria. The ships also stopped in Copenhagen, Denmark, and Karlskrona, Sweden. During the voyage back to Austria-Hungary, the squadron visited Cherbourg, France, and Palermo, Italy. Kronprinz Erzherzog Rudolf experienced repeated difficulties with her engines on the trip, but it was nevertheless considered to be a great success in the Austro-Hungarian Navy celebrations to honor the 400th anniversary of Christopher Columbus's first transatlantic voyage were held in several countries. Kronprinz Erzherzog Rudolf, Kronprinzessin Erzherzogin Stephanie, and Kaiser Franz Joseph I represented Austria-Hungary during the ceremonies in Genoa, Italy, Columbus's birthplace. While there, she was inspected by King Umberto I of Italy and his son Victor Emmanuel III. Already by 1898, the ship was regarded by the Austro-Hungarian Navy as a second-rate vessel. After less than 10 years in service, the rapid pace of naval development in the late 19th century had quickly rendered her obsolescent. Kronprinz Erzherzog Rudolf was reclassified as a coastal defense ship in 1906. In 1908, the Austro-Hungarian Navy attempted to sell the ship, Kronprinzessin Erzherzogin Stephanie, and Tegetthoff to Uruguay in an attempt to raise funds for new projects, but the deal fell through after Austria-Hungary declared war on Serbia in July 1914, beginning World War I. The ship was stationed in Kataro Bay under Commander Richard Florio, the leader of Mining Command II. The force also included an old destroyer, four torpedo boats, a minelayer, and two minesweepers, among other minor vessels. She remained there for the duration of the conflict. By early 1918, the long periods of inactivity had begun to wear on the crews of several warships at Kataro, including Kronprinz Erzherzog Rudolf. On 1 February, the Kataro Mutiny broke out, starting aboard the armored cruiser Sankt Georg and quickly spreading to other ships. Officers were confined to their quarters while a committee of sailors met to formulate a list of demands, which ranged from longer periods of leave and better rations to an end to the war, based on the United States President Woodrow Wilson's 14 points. The following day, shore batteries loyal to the government fired on Kronprinz Erzherzog Rudolf as she steamed to the Bay of Teodo, the outermost part of Kataro Bay. The batteries scored a single hit that killed two men, which prompted many of the mutinous ships to abandon the effort on the morning of 3 February, the Erzherzog Karl class. Kronprinz Erzherzog Rudolf was transferred to the fledgling Royal Yugoslav Navy, who renamed her Kumbor. She remained in the Yugoslav inventory only briefly, being broken up for scrap in 1922. Notes: Carat Gardiner, p. 267. Carat Sondhaus, pp. 37-39. Carat Sondhaus, p. 54. Carat ABC Sondhaus, p. 86. Carat Sondhaus, p. 100. Carat ABCDEFGHIJ Gardiner, p. 271. Carat Gardiner, p. 272. Carat ABCDEF The New Austrian Ironclad, p. 141. Carat Sondhaus, p. 90. Carat Sondhaus, p. 110. Carat Sondhaus, p. 112. Carat Sondhaus, pp. 144-158. Carat ABC Gardiner. The New Austrian Ironclad Industries, a Journal of Engineering, Electricity. Kronprinzessin Erzherzogin Stephanie's Monarch Armored Cruisers Kaiserin und Königin Maria Theresias Kaiser Karl vis Sankt Georgs Protected Cruisers Kaiser Franz Joseph I Scout Cruisers Admiral Spahn's Novara Light Cruisers Panther Tigers Zenta Ersatz Zentax Destroyers Meteors Blitz Planets Trabants Satellite Magnets Hussar Warazdiners Tatra Ersatz Tatrax U-Boats U-1 U-3 U-5 U-7 U-10 U-14 C-U-20 U-27 U-43 U-48 U-50 U-52 U-101 U-107 Auxiliaries Pola S single ship of class 10 cancelled sea captured,